Howdy, friends. My name is Duke, and I do believe it is time for a stream. I know it's been a little while. I was out sick with a little bit of the old influenza. Hold on, I just have to get a couple things set up real quick. Should have done this before I started, but I'm never prepared when I start these things, so why start now? That's not what I meant to do. Hell. Hey, what's up, Privacy? So I was actually pretty sick. I mean, I wasn't dying or anything, but I missed 3 days of work, and then I was still sick for most of the 3 day weekend right after that. The normal weekend plus Martin Luther King Jr. Day, which is a holiday here. And I'm feeling a lot better. Pretty much 100% better, I'd say. I'm still a little, you know, I haven't talked in a while, so I'm still a little bit rusty on that front. I did get a lot of ISIC done during that time. As you can see, I've done quite a few more hard runs. I've beaten Mom's Heart with every character on hard, which means I've unlocked all of the co-op players, the babies. So that'll be fun the next time I do some co-op. Had a couple of really good runs with Judas playing on hard. I don't know how I pulled that off. I hate Judas. But that's pretty satisfying, seeing 5 red icons there. And I've cleared pretty much everything not on hard, except for the dark room with Magdalene and the dark room with Eve. I didn't mean for those, you know, the two female characters to be the ones I haven't completely cleared. It just kind of worked out that way. So I'm wondering if I should just try to beat them on normal first, just to get all of the icons on there, or if I should just suck it up and play on hard. Not sure. I should probably just play on hard, make things a little bit more interesting, and I'm going to have to play on hard eventually anyway, so why not? So Eve or Magdalene? I like both characters about the same. I mean, neither of them are my go-to characters, but I guess I'll be Eve. Still haven't done any of the challenges. I'm waiting. That's a pretty good first item to find. I'm waiting until, you know, all the challenges I wanted to do on stream, so I haven't messed around with any of those yet. Oh yeah, there's two locked doors on this floor, so hopefully I will find 2 keys, especially since I have all this money to spend now. Well, off to a great start. Hey, Sarah the Lich, what's up? Alright, I got my shitty run out of the way early. Nothing but awesome runs from here on out. Man, I just got really unlucky to be hit by 2 of the champion enemies in that room. I guess that's kind of the whole point of playing on hard, though. We have more of the champions to deal with. And now I can't see my health, which will make this run that much more interesting. Still haven't unlocked the Lost or anything. I'll probably at least try to unlock the Lost at some point, because there are item combinations that even with the Lost I should be able to win the game with. There are item combinations that don't come up too often, but it's not out of the realm of possibility, which is screwing up the stream. Oh, I forgot to mention, I got my internet bandwidth increased after the first of the year. I have 5 megabits per second upload speed instead of about 2 that I had before. So I increased the quality of the stream in my settings, So if a lot of you are having issues with the higher bitrate, let me know, and I'll go back to playing at a lower bitrate setting. I'm not using all 5 megabits of my upload bandwidth. I have it set to about 3, which is twice what I had set at before, so hopefully it should look a little nicer for most people. But, I mean, if Twitch is going to have issues, then I might want to go back to what I was using before. Of course, it might not be my settings at all. It might just be Twitch being Twitch. So I didn't really announce the stream or anything ahead of time, because I didn't know if I would feel like streaming. So after I recovered from my illness, we started doing overtime at work this past week, starting on Tuesday. So that's why I haven't been streaming in the afternoons, even after my health improved. But that's what weekends are for, right? 9:30 on a Saturday night seems like a pretty good time to sit at home and play video games in a room by myself. But I'm not by myself. I have Sarah the Lich and Privacy Eve. Oh, hey, and Oxbow now. Hello, Oxbow. Oxbow had to change his Twitch password. If anyone else in the chat room is having issues besides Sarah, let me know, and I will restart the stream with my old bandwidth settings. Oh yeah, that's right, PAX is going on, so I guess Twitch might be more... Hey! Twitch might be under more strain than usual. Not sure what all is being streamed out of PAX, Private Steve says his is fixed. That's good. Wish Twitch would fix the fact that it goes to hell once some big event comes on. Yeah, I thought about switching the hitbox on more than one occasion. I mean, the thing is, with Twitch, it's always... It's never everybody having the same issue watching the stream. It's always... You know, just a small percentage of my viewers. Which, I mean, it sucks. But, I mean, I'm not sure there's much I can do about it. I mean, I could switch a hitbox, but... I don't know. I like being on Twitch because... It means a lot of people can randomly find my streams and subscribe to me, and it makes me feel good when that happens. On Hitbox, I never get just, you know, random people looking for a game, finding my stream and subscribing. Oh, is there a new Dark Bomb? Well, let's see, I have 10 coins. I have plenty of keys, so might as well check out the shop. Alright. So what I'm going to do is, since I picked up that soul heart, I'm going to go on ahead and see what's in the pain room. Ah, that sucks. See you later, Sarah. If you're watching this later on YouTube, then I apologize for... the issues with the stream. Oh hell. The bombs, oh well. Alright, amnesia, oh well. So I've been playing a lot more, or I guess I should say a lot less conservatively when it comes to the devil rooms and such. Like, I've been taking a lot of devil deals lately. Because it seems like with Rebirth, there's a lot more incentive to give up your normal hearts and just roll with soul hearts. Maybe that was the case in the original Isaac 2. But it feels like not having red hearts isn't that big of a deal. Especially on hard, because red hearts just don't really drop that often. So I feel like trading. Oops. Oh. Well, I guess that saved me a key, so why not go ahead and use it, even though I didn't intend to. Oh yeah, they do make him drop spiders sometimes. So this guy is pretty cool, but I'm not really using him to his full potential. What the Mongo Baby does is, if you have other familiars, he will fire whatever kind of shots they fire. And if you have more than one familiar that fires shots, it randomly chooses between them. But since I don't have any other familiars, he just has normal tiers, which still isn't bad. I mean, his fire rate is pretty good. But if I could get, like, I don't know, the Demon Baby or something, that'd be pretty awesome. Bombs are key, eh? Well, glad I have that Stars card. Especially now that I have the Dark Bomb from the beginning, I'm going to be especially hoping for good Devil Room items. Well, I got these bombs, I guess I might as well look for secrets. Nice. What kind of bug, Private Steve? Huh, that's weird. Is that something that's preventing you from playing the game, or did it fix it once you restarted? Kind of weird to think of people playing this game not on the PC, because the original was just such a PC, such a PC-oriented game. And it's just because it was made in Flash. It was hard to imagine the original being on any console or anything. Well, sure. I have all this money. Ooh, blank card. Or the tarot card generator. Almost buy both. I don't know, I wouldn't want to spend all my money on this stuff, though. If I find a good tarot card, or other kind of card, I'll go ahead and pick up the blank one. But it seems like 99% of the time, whenever I get the blank card, I never find anything that makes it worth it. Oh, it happens at random, that sucks. Hope they patch that soon. Come on, something good. Well, two soul hearts is pretty good. Better than nothing. I would have liked brimstone or something, though. Alright, I have all these soul hearts. I might as well check out the pain room now. I feel pretty good about playing with the controller too, Oxbow. I'm using a PS2 controller, but same principle, I'd say. Well, that was worth it. Kinda like to get that stuff, but spikes deal a full heart of damage to you, and it's not worth giving up 2 soul hearts just to open a chest, so I'll leave that stuff alone. I guess I could bomb them, so I can get them without walking on the spikes, but it's not really worth using 2 bombs either. So, down I go. I've also been less conservative about bombing stuff as well. Like, if I have more than 2 bombs, I'd probably try bombing some of these mushrooms, just because you have a chance of getting the, I forget what it's called, the mushroom that, like, the red one that increases all of your stats by 1. These can drop that mushroom sometimes. But since I only have 2 bombs, I'd kind of rather look for secrets at the moment. Very comfortable controllers, yeah. Like, when I was playing on PC, I never bothered trying to set up Joy to Key, because I felt like the keyboard controls were fine. But now that I've started using a PS2 controller, I don't know if I can go back to the keyboard. Health down. Well, this was a pretty crappy challenge room. 3 red chests and no guppy items. That is rather unfortunate. And a health down. And I got hit. Oh well. Yeah, same Oxbow. Like, something about the way Rebirth is balanced makes me want to just kind of go crazy with taking risks and stuff. Like, in the original, I would normally never even bother with the pain rooms if I had soul hearts. But in this version, I'm like, why not? Aw. Well. Nice. Okay, I don't feel so bad about... Oh yeah, that's right. Oh, I should have pushed one of those bombs into this thing. Oh well. Wasn't thinking. The Emperor, well, I can teleport out of here and not have to take the extra hit. I might as well do that. Kind of bummed about getting an angel room instead of a devil room, but I got flight out of it, so... One of the best outcomes that could have happened with that. Some damage or tears upgrades would be pretty nice. HP and luck up? Well, not exactly what I was looking for. Yeah, in general, I'd rather have a devil room than an angel room, Oxbow. Especially since I learned that... Shit. I learned that if you only have one red heart container and a devil room item costs 2, you can take it and there's no punishment for that. like as long as you have enough soul hearts, like it won't take a red heart and a soul heart. It'll just take the one red heart, which is pretty nice. Man, this room would suck if I couldn't fly. Yeah, the Holy Mantle and the Trinity Shield are also two very, very good items. Ooh. Item murder. That's cool. Now I just need an item. Oh shit, I was close enough to that. It looked close enough. Oh yeah. This thing. Yeah, might as well pick that up. Well, let's see. Secret room is definitely not here. So, not sure where else. Well, could be next to the challenge room. Not sure. Could be saved with one heart. Nice. Well done, Private Steve. Those are the kind of moments in this game that really make it exhilarating. When you pull off something like that, when you beat Satan or Isaac or the Blue Baby or whoever with very little health and you have no idea how you pulled it off. Very good feeling. I always think these bats explode when you kill them because they look kind of similar to the bomb flies as far as their color goes. But nope, they just die. A health down pill isn't the worst thing to hang on to because if you only have one red heart, it turns into a health up pill. Similar to the way the bad trip pill turns into a full health pill. Bloody Lust. That's not bad. It works differently than the way it worked in the original Isaac because it's based on or I might be thinking of a different item. It might work the same way. I think now it's based on the number of hits you take in a level. Yeah, that's right. It's based on the number of hits you take in a level instead of the number of enemies you kill in a room. That's the way Bloody Lust used to work, I believe. Unless I do have it mixed up with another item. Right, so I already tried bombing there, so let's try this place. Aw. I could blow that up and see what the other item in the item shop was. I think I'll just save my money. I do want to go back and bomb some of these mushrooms, though. Nice. I wasn't sure if I could get all six of those or not. Bummer. Oh, is that what Samson's Lock does? That's cool. So the original Bloody Lust is still in the game, just in a different form. Yeah, I like how it works for the entire floor, but I've always been opposed to items that don't do anything unless you get hit. Because I try to get hit as little as possible, so kind of biased against it in that respect. Arcade. Apparently, you only need 5 coins for the arcade to show up. I always thought it was more. Mysterious paper. So I believe the mysterious paper can have the effect of either the Polaroid or the negative, or other items that take up a trinket slot and are paper. So like the wanted poster or the missing page or anything like that. But I still don't know what the wanted poster does, so not sure if that's good or not. Explaining Samson desirable. Yeah, that's true. I've definitely had some good combos where apparently that thing explodes. Where I use a blood donation machine, a whole bunch of Samson, and just get my tears up a whole lot. Make a melee build, yeah. Eh. That's worth holding on to for using the blood machine, if there is one in the arcade. And it sucks that you're not guaranteed a blood machine in every arcade anymore. Amnesia never good for anything. Ooh, I could use this guy instead of the blood machine. I think I'd rather go that route. Oh yeah, and also I'm Eve, so it's actually desirable to get my health down most of the way. Oh. That must be, that effect must be similar to the Polaroid. I don't know why it was red, though. Two of diamonds? Sure. Go to the item room? Yeah, why not? Look at my tears now. Heck yeah! Oh, I agreed. Guess what? I have spectral tears, so, you know, I'm not really as afraid of you as I would normally be. And even with the Horror Babylon and Bloody Lust, my tears still aren't great. I mean, they're good. They're just not great. Oh, is that what the missing page does? I thought the missing page was the Necronomicon effect. They might have changed it, though. I can use these explosive diarrhea pills to blow up some mushrooms. Another one? Oh no, that's telepills. Okay, well, why not? Nice! Oh. This is a weird I am error room. Nice. Oh, Dark Bum being generous with the soul hearts. I don't even need that one. Alright, well, nothing else I can do, I guess. Yeah, I'll hold on to the petrified poop. Your stream keeps randomly skipping forward? Really? What the hell? Is the stream normal for you, Oxbow? Because Private Steve and Sarah both said they can't see the stream or they're having too many issues with it. Now look at how crappy. Oh wait, for some reason the Horror Babylon doesn't take effect when the level starts. You always have to go into another room. But yeah, my tears aren't as crappy as they looked. But still, losing that rage effect took most of the wind out of my sails. Long delay and the buffers, really? Well, shit. Okay. When this run's finished, I will try lowering my bitrate back to the normal amount and see if that helps. Usual twitch, slightly more than normal. Yeah, screw this. After this run, I'm just going to use hitbox. Because, yeah, I don't get the random drive-by traffic, but I never really got that much anyway, so I won't be losing that much. Now that there's a Soul Heart Lane there, I wanna make use of this guy. Shit. Which was pretty good for a while there, it seemed like. I didn't have a ton of issues with it until my last couple streams. Like, I don't know if it's because PAX is going on or if it's just Twitch being Twitch. Hoping once Amazon bought Twitch, it would mean the end of these issues, but apparently not. Well, I can use the full health pill to use the Dark Bomb. Man, I took a lot of damage. I just lost like 3 soul hearts. Oh wait, I never picked up the other soul heart, that's right. I was heading in that direction, but I think I got teleported because of the maze. Oops. I forgot to use the pill. Nice. I should probably use that bombs or key pill so I can get into the item room. Yeah, like, there's some people who just who are never able to use Twitch. That sucks. Shit. I rarely have issues when I'm watching Twitch. That's the other thing. Like, usually when I have Twitch issues, well, it's hard to say whose fault it is, really, if it's Twitch or if it's the person who's streaming. But, like, that does not happen very often. Nice, I needed some keys. Experimental item, Oxbow? Not sure which one you mean the experimental treatment? The one that increases all of your stats and then shuffles them? Yeah, that never really seems to do that much for me either. Like, I always end up either losing health or my tears being way worse after I pick it up. And the trade-off is, like, I'm a little faster or a little luckier or something. I keep fearing the worst from the Dark Bum. Shit! Damn it, Duke, stop holding the D-pad when you go into a room. How many times do I have to tell you that? Oops, shit, I should have let the Dark One pick that up. Oh well. Oh god. Yeah, exactly. Always screws my damage too. Yeah, he hasn't dropped any spiders yet. Which I'm sure the next time he picks up a heart, he's going to drop a spider now that I've said that. Well, hell. I have all this money, so... Even though I don't have an item yet, there's a possibility that I will pick up an item eventually. So I'll go ahead and get the 9 volt, and I'll buy that and this. And I'll just donate some so it breaks. Oh, hey, I got the next door upgrade. Sweet. How many was that? 600? Cool. I didn't know there was another store upgrade coming. I mean, I assumed there would be since the donation machine goes up to 999. But I wasn't sure when the next one would occur. Dang. They never accept that much money. Okay, so I guess the store upgrade won't take effect until the next level, which makes sense. Is that Dark Beggar still on this level? Because if so, I'll go ahead and buy that heart. Get 2 more uses out of him. I think he is. I don't remember. He's not showing up on the map, but I forget if they show up on the map in this version or not. Really, this is an XL level. I don't know why I was thinking this was a Curse of the Maze level. Good run for the donation, yeah. Took a crap load of my money. Oh yeah, I have a key now, so I might as well do that. Oh, that paid off. Wait, oh yeah, that's right, I have full health now. was wondering, why do my tears suck again? Man, I hope that Dark Beggar is on this level. Otherwise, I kind of screwed myself by picking up all that health. Oh wait, it's a friendly spider. I was about to say, see, I told you it would be a spider, but I mean, I was technically right, it was a spider. Yeah, there he is. Hello, friend. Nice. Gimpy. So I have an even better chance of getting soul hearts now. Alright, I have 5 bombs, and I haven't tested very many walls or secret doors, so I guess I should do that. Yeah, didn't the arcade stuff used to show up on the map? I always thought there was an icon for slot machines / beggars / blood donation machines. I guess they might have changed that, but I don't know why. Eve is a rough character to use. Sometimes. I'm having a pretty good run with her, though. Getting the Bloodlust was a good synergy with the Whore of Babylon. Good incentive to knock down my red hearts. Get my damage up. Shit! God, I hate these things. Oh, I forget what this one does. I think that's the Trail of Tears thing. Yeah, that's cool. Not a bad item. The mulligan. Mulligan's triggers when I get hit thing, isn't it? Yeah, I'm like Eve / Samson. Good combo. Don't mind if I do. Well, it's another locked door over here. Let's see what we have. Oh wait, no, that's just a shop. Never mind. Well, secret door might be next to the shop. Seen it happen before. Nope, okay, I don't know then. Not here. Oh wait, I already got it. I'm dumb. Oh yeah, that's right. It was just a key. That's why I didn't remember. Because it was such an unmemorable secret room. Hard to pay attention to games when you're talking sometimes. One thing I learned in my career as a streamer. Oh, flies can spawn when I hit an enemy. Okay, that's cool. Ugh, I don't like the adversary. I don't like that homing brimstone attack he has. Too difficult to dodge. I got lucky with it that time. Speed up and size down. Oh yeah, that's right. I'm a mom already. That's cool. Shit. still don't have anything that works with my Mongo baby. That's kind of disappointing. Shit. Crud. I took a lot of damage. Hey. That's pretty cool. Good item to get. Yeah, two adversaries in the same fight is rough. Hard to deal with. I can pop my card. That map might be a little bit too transparent. There we go. I was experimenting with the map opacity because it seemed like having the map opaque always kind of screwed me, not being able to see things behind it. Having the shield specifically makes the final boss fights a lot easier. Especially Isaac and the Blue Baby. Oops, shit. I did not mean to pick that up. Oh well, I'm still safe. Well, I can skip a room if I use a bomb, but not worth it just to skip one room. It's an easy room anyway. Dang, too bad there are no locked doors on this level. I guess I'm not going to get any devil rooms because I picked up angel room items. I think that's how that works. I think taking items in one prevents the other from ever showing up. But that's okay. Like Oxbow said, I got two of the best angel room items in one run. Oh hey, Sore Thumb, what's up? Let me know how the stream looks for you because a lot of people have been having issues with it. And I'm thinking of moving the stream to Hitbox. So Strength, I learned, is one of the best cards you can get. Because it gives you a temporary stat boost, or it temporarily increases all of your stats in the room you're in. And that includes your health. So, if you use it in the devil room, you can get a temporary heart to give to the devil to get an item. But like I said, I don't think I'll be getting any devil rooms on this run, so I probably won't be able to use it for that. But it's a nice strategy I picked up. No, Sword Thumb, I'm not the lost. I forget what it's called, but it gives you flight and spectral tears, and you find it in the angel rooms. And I have the Curse of the Unknown for this playthrough, so it makes it look like a lot like the Lost run, but I actually haven't even unlocked the Lost yet. Dead Dove, yeah, that's it. Wonder how much health I have. Probably not much, because I haven't picked up any soul hearts since the mom fight. It is kind of interesting that the Lost Sprite is basically just the same sprite as the Dead Dove thing. I never really noticed that before. And also the same sprite as Spirit of the Night, I think. But that one's black instead of white. Alright, so this will be what, a Mr. Fred room? Oh no. Double the gate, wow. That kind of sucks. At least when you have when you have to fight two stationary bosses like the gate or Gertie or whoever, it's usually pretty easy to deal with one of them at a time, because the gate number two, I'm too far away for it to really do anything to me except spawn these headless jumping guys. Aw, what hit me? Oh, I guess it was this guy. Oh, hey, Devil Room. Sweet. Let's grab that. Nice. Okay, so I can pop my strength card, so I only have to lose one red heart instead of two. And I'm definitely taking Brimstone. Charge is pretty fast. My tier rate wasn't horrible. Alright, sweet. Alright, anything else I want to do on this level? I don't think so. You kill yourself in the sacrifice room with it equipped, you see a hint to unlocking the lost. Oh! That's interesting. I didn't know there were any hints to unlocking the lost. Nice! Alright, that was a pretty good boss challenge room. I'm feeling much better about my health situation now. Those two were chumps, yeah. They were a couple of chumps. Alright, so I can go in here and then use telepills to get out. Might as well do that. Oh wait, that's right, I'm flying, so I don't even take the first hit. That's cool. I don't know why that happens, but I'm glad it does. This is the first time I've gotten Pandora's Box. I just unlocked it recently. Pandora's Box has a different effect depending on which floor you use it on. And I don't remember what the effect in the womb is. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and use it now. Why not? Oh hey, that's cool. Be able to kill Mom's heart in one hit. And I don't have an activated item, so there's no reason not to take it. Nice, and it teleported me to the secret room. I got this by the ass, yeah, hopefully. Stuff can still go wrong, Oxbow. Oh wait, that's right. Man, Brimstone plus the mulligan. It's just as good as Brimstone plus Guppy, really. Jesus Christ, look at all those flies. Well, something to spend my wealth on. Huh. Something else for me to spend my wealth on, I guess. Well, I mean, I'm good on Soul Hearts for a while, so I guess there's no point in continuing. I'll get more bombs and keys, but meh. Shit. Shouldn't have taken a hit there. You can get up to 2 items with Pandora's box. Yeah, I do remember reading that on the wiki, but I didn't remember which floor gave you the 2 items, so. My mulligan doesn't seem to be as effective right now. It's weird. Why is it not spawning anything anymore? Samson's lock. So now I have both rage effects. Interesting. Not sure how much of a difference it'll make now that I have brimstone. But I mean, the poop doesn't really do that much for you from the womb on, so I might as well keep it. Nice. Full up on soul hearts. I wonder why the mulligan isn't as cool as it used to be. Oops. Shit. Probably should have stopped charging. The world, eh? I'll hold on to that for the next floor. I could go back and just keep using the slot machine, but not really worth it. The stacks with Bloody Lust could help on a boss fight. It's pretty limited at this point. Yeah, you're probably right. Oops. I hit the card button instead of the item button. That was foolish. Oh well. Might as well pick up this now, even though I only have 1 heart, so it's not going to do much for me. I guess I should take the slot machine now, because now that I've killed Mom's heart, or now that I've killed it lives, there's no reason to hold on to the Bibles since I can fly. Where was the slot machine? Oh, was it in the secret room? No? Oh, there is. Launching up on the map for some reason. Oh, I guess it was. I just couldn't see it because I was in the room. So now when I get hit, I can just keep using the slot machine until my dark bum friend gives me a soul heart. Thank you. Come on. Thanks, friend. Wait. Oh, that's this? That's a chest room. There's not an actual chest in there. Okay. Different icon. Yeah, I hate burning poop too. It lulls you into a false sense of security. You think it's not going to do anything to you because, hey, it's just poop. You don't pay as close attention to it as you would an actual enemy. I guess it's not opening because my Mongo friend is shooting at him. Eh. Yeah, hold on to the slot machine. Better to have a chance to get soul hearts. And I have brimstone, so Bob's rotten head would just be kind of redundant at this point. Well, now the mulligan's doing stuff again. It's weird. Like, is it only bosses or something? I don't know. No, because it worked well with those guys. I don't know. And I didn't like this room the first time. Bad place for you to sit, Mega Mall. I don't know why I still have this full health pill. It's literally not going to do with anything for me. Shit. Probably hold on to these bombs because I'm going to have to fight Satan. I'll just use my slot machine some more. Coins aren't useless, Oxbow. They let me feed my slot machine. Or is that what you're saying? That getting the slot machine is the only way coins will be useful? That's true. My luck isn't the best, so it's not 100% useful, but it's better than just having a bunch of coins I can't do anything with. Really? Picked up a whole heart and you didn't give me anything? Pretty crappy pill pool this time around, to be honest. I don't know why I had trouble saying that. Pill pool. Hey, a black heart, cool. Hey, what's up, Just Drop? Yeah, it's lagging for everyone. I'm probably going to switch to hitbox after this run. I mean, I'm streaming at a higher bitrate, but I actually have enough bandwidth to handle it now because my bandwidth got improved at the first of the year. Hey, let me check and make sure I'm not dropping frames or anything. Nope, dropped frames zero. So I'm pretty sure it's Twitch. I'm assuming everyone who's watching me has at least a 3 megabit a second connection. But I mean, maybe not. I mean, if Hitbox is still causing people problems, then I guess I'll go back to what I was streaming at before. See, you guys just need to promote me and make it so I get really famous, so I get a ton of followers, and Twitch gives me quality options on my stream. Clearly, that's the best solution. And the mulligan, it's kind of hit or miss. I guess it's not as good as Guppy. I don't know why sometimes it seems really good and sometimes it doesn't do anything for me. Maybe the percentage, maybe the odds change from room to room. Maybe I had a 5% chance of spawning flies last time and now I have a 4% chance or something. Oh my god, I'm not exactly sure what the deal is. Is Twitch being Twitch? Yeah, or it's screwed up by increasing my bitrate. I mean, it could be all my fault, guys, and if so, I apologize. I just wanted the stream to look nicer. Crap. It's a bad room. I guess it's not a horrible room. Yeah, I should look for secrets before I fight the boss. Well, no, actually, I should save my bombs. Never mind. Check this out. Yes, kill each other. Nice. Wonder what made that so hard drop. Nice. Only took one hit. It wasn't so bad. Right, I'm gonna go back for that soul heart. Yeah, the Fallen is my favorite enemy to use pheromones on. Still have 5 bombs, so make use of them, I guess. Nice, and it dropped a soul heart that I don't need. Well, let's go ahead and pump all my money into this, and then I'll take the blank card. Can this thing give tarot cards out? Because that'd be pretty cool if it could. Man, I wish there. Well, I guess I could use the sacrifice room. Make use of these soul hearts. Better than nothing, I guess. I still don't know exactly how these rooms work. Like, they're the one room that I always skip. Because, oh yeah. Because I just don't know. Like, it never seems worth it to me. Like, if I didn't have all these extra hearts laying around, I would never bother with the sacrifice room. Oh, one more. Eh. I don't even know what that does. Be cool if I could pick up like the Hierophant or the Death card or something cool like that. Probably won't happen though. Oh wait, shit! I should have taken the telepills. Pill. Oh well. Enough stalling. Soul Converter, eh? You see, this is kind of a risk, because it could be 9 lives. And if it's 9 lives, I'm screwed, because that'll make me lose all my soul hearts. Oh, go ahead. That's kind of cool, I guess. I'll keep the blank card unless I take a bunch of damage. Then I'll sacrifice my last red heart, Paul. Shit. God, there's so many of these things. Well, I guess I might as well use it now. Damn it. Improves the chance of keys and golden chest dropping after clearing a room. And chance of finding a key when opening a chest. Oh, well, that actually sounds kind of useful. Oh well. I still say flying should protect you from those floor spikes. That's some major league bullcrap. Double dark one, eh? Ramming speed. I guess it just makes me faster. Oh, Mr. Longlegs? Shit. I avoided getting hit by Daddy Longlegs and I get hit by a freaking spider. I mean, I guess Daddy Longlegs is technically a spider, but you know what I mean. Little Han. Hey, that's kind of cool. Yeah, the husks suck. Oh my god, there's three of them? Shit. Dark Room doesn't mess around. Is this the first time I've been to the Dark Room on stream? I forget. Might be. Is the one that goes Game Kid. It's not the, I didn't get the Rage's building thing, right? Is that the one you mean? I got Ares. The Ram. Yeah, I don't know if having Samson's Lock is doing that much for me. But then again, I don't know if any other trinket would have done anything for me either. Taking quite a bit of damage here. Kinda sucks. Thanks. Alright, see you later, Sore Thumb. I'm going to try streaming on Hitbox after this run, so... So if you still want to watch, then give that a try. Yep, here's that double adversary room I was talking about earlier. Or Oxbow was talking about. And it's not even the right fucking way. Great. Wow, this is a lot of the Fallen. And it's still not the right way. Great. Man, it's going to be really embarrassing if I lose this one with all this awesome stuff I have. Well, at least I have Brimstone, so dealing with the masks isn't going to be a big deal. Oh, get myself 16 bombs. Sounds like a good idea. Great. Of course, when I picked up the blank card, not a single card drops. What always happens. The lamb isn't that hard, really. I say this is an easier fight than Isaac or the blue baby. Alright, body's dead. Just gotta focus on the head now. Shit! Did not see that attack coming. Fuck. Well, I came close. Honestly, I would have had this if I didn't pick the three wrong directions to go before figuring out which was the right direction. It's going all over the freaking dark room that killed me. Alright, I'm going to switch to Hitbox, so if you're still watching, go to hitbox.tv/DukeOfTheBump and see if you have better luck there. I'm going to stop streaming and then resume streaming in a minute on Hitbox. So hopefully see everyone there. If you're watching on YouTube, then the next video should be going up shortly. Bye.